This is a test. 3, Zane McClure. Number 20, Jackson Mann. Number 21, Tucker Emery. And number 33, Isaiah Harris. And now for your CRA Falcons, number 3, Reese Napier. Number 11, T.J. Spillman. Number 12, Doss Clayton. Number 13, Braxton Dunn. And number 15, Caden Prager.
team. Still can't.
Hello, testing.
Okay.
All right. All right, welcome to tonight's ball game. Had a little bit of technical difficulties. Riverside up 4-0 here early on in the first quarter, 6:52 to go. Good to have everybody with us tonight. I've got a steal there. Lathan Brinkley with the steal. Coming down court. Sam Marshall with a long three, misses, comes off. Riverside ball. It's our first ball game tonight, our first official ball game tonight against Riverside. Riverside's always a tough team. A little bit bigger school than ours. They've had a very successful program. Don't have a play-by-play guy tonight, so we're going to try to do this the best that we can with just me here with you tonight. We got a foul on Lathan Brinkley. That'll be his first foul. Gillis at the line. Sticks it next to the backboard in the free throw. That'll go down as a no basket. Not sure I've ever seen that on a free throw before. I've saw that on dunks. I've seen it on outside shots, but never on a free throw. I take a second shot. It's up. It's no good. Oh, Riverside player hits the deck hard, kind of got a little bit undercut, but that was more his doing than our doing. Yeah, that was a little bit of a late call right there. That probably should have been a no call. That was more of Riverside's player being aggressive than it was our player fouling him. But and Cole Oxley with a nice slap away right there. Lathan Brinkley picks it up. Sam Marshall driving down, passes it back out to Lathan. Luke Summit takes it, got a wide open lane, made it, nice play, Luke. 4-2, cut that lead in half right there, Luke, with a nice drive. Luke's kind of known as a solid defender, but he actually has some pretty good moves offensively, and just as I speak, Luke comes up with a foul. Been his problem here in the past. Getting in early foul trouble, really can't afford to do that tonight. I don't have a really deep bench this year. A lot of sophomores. Riverside comes down, shoots a little eight footer, misses it. Sam Marshall got the ball now, dribbling past half court. Hands it off to Lathan, Lathan to Luke. Luke drives in, gets it blocked, gets a pass blocked. They get an easy bucket for two. Riverside up 6-2. Riverside with full court press right now. We'll see how we handle that. We've got it past half court. Should have an open player. We do right there. Nice play. Lathan kind of lost the handle going up for the basket. Missed the basket. Riverside with a rebound. CRA knocked out of bounds. Riverside up 6-2 with about 4:50 left in this first quarter. Said early on, I'm not sure what game this is for Riverside. It's our first official game we've played in a jamboree, but this is our first game that means something. Riverside setting up their full court press again. Let's see if we can break it like we did last time. Sam Marshall taking the ball out. Everybody on this side of the court. Don't normally see that. Should have a breakaway. We do. Lathan's wide open underneath. They didn't see him. Cole's got the ball. Drove in. Nice play, Cole. Cole up for two. 6-4 right now. We're staying. We're hanging in there with them. CRA traditionally plays pretty good first quarter, second quarter. Stay with them. And looks like that trend's continuing. Riverside working the ball around the perimeter. Not a very big team this year. They usually have a pretty good center forwards on their team. This year it looks like their biggest guy looks about 6'2". They usually have a couple of 6'4 guys on their team, but not this year. Got to reach in foul on Luke. That's two on him early on. Coach Clothier probably thinking about needing to give him a break here with just 4 minutes left to go in the first quarter, and he's already got two fouls. This year, new feature to high school basketball is the shot clock. Keep the action going a little bit. Hop, they count it, shot it at the buzzer. They made it, now they've doubled our score. It's 8-4, Riverside. Sam bringing it up, back to Luke. Best way to beat a full court press is to get an easy basket underneath the basket. We did, just threw one away right there. They'll keep that press on as long as we have trouble with it. 3:30 left in the first quarter, 8-4 Riverside. The Summit's got two, Cole Oxley's got two on this game. They just made a three-pointer, number 24, Durham. First three-pointer tonight. Riverside with the steal. We steal it back. Threw it away. That's going to be a foul on Lathan Brinkley. That's two on him. We're going to be in trouble if we lose those two guys this early. Two fouls on Lathan. Two fouls on Luke. 11-4 Riverside with 3:06 in the first quarter. Riverside comes down. Drives the basket. Gets the foul. So opportunity for the old-fashioned three-pointer. Tim's with that shot for Riverside. Got a timeout for CRA at this point. I think it's a full timeout. 11-4. Take this opportunity to congratulate our senior high girls volleyball team. They made it to the state tournament after winning the district last week. Played Central Christian today down in Searcy, won three games and lost none today, so they move on to the second round to play the winner of Harding Academy. I'm not sure who they play tonight, but it's at Harding Academy. They are the number two seed from their district at home, so I would guess that that's probably be who our girls play tomorrow. So keep them in mind, and hopefully they'll continue their success down in Searcy tomorrow. But congratulations to them and their first round win. Back out on the court, Riverside at the line, shooting the single free throw that he'll get. He makes it, so that's 3 point for Timms. Still full court press by Riverside. Looks like we're breaking it pretty good. We're just not finishing very good. We're a little weak on our passes down low. Sam Marshall driving inside. Dishes it back out to Cole. Cole misses three-pointer. Sam Marshall with the foul. Slap from behind. Riverside up 14-4 with 2:41 to go in the first quarter. They're already in the bonus. 44 shoots up. He misses. Front end of the 1-1. Come down with the rebound. We got a few new players in the game. Hayden Austin entered the game. Lathan Brinkley sitting out with a couple of fouls. Got a holding foul against Riverside. Number 14. It'll be Durham. That'll be his first foul. Ciara taking the ball out underneath their basket. Sam Marshall passes in to Hayden Austin. It's off a Riverside player. We get the ball back out on the opposite side of the basket at this point. Sam bringing it back in. Out to the top, the key to Luke. Luke into Hayden. Hayden back out to Luke. Cole looking for three. Sided against it, drove the basket. A nice drive, couldn't finish. Riverside down with the rebound. Getting a little wild on this end. I could see it getting that way. 4-4. Gillis with the basket. I believe that's his second bucket. So he's got 4 points for Riverside. CRA still trying to beat the press and get across half court. Riverside with steal, breakaway, easy layup. The game's kind of getting away from us right now. It's 18-4, Riverside. Minute and a half to go in the first quarter. Still full court pressing us. We just threw it away again. Riverside with the steal and the drive and a foul on Cole Oxley. Been informed that Lathan Brinkley has 4 fouls on the official book. I only had him down for 2. I will probably be making a few more mistakes as the night goes on, just trying to keep the book play by play and keep in tune what's going on here, but I'm going to do the best I can. Into the first quarter, it's 19-4. Once again, appreciate you joining us tonight on Facebook or YouTube, and got a decent crowd tonight. I know there's quite a few that traveled down to watch the girls play volleyball today, as they should. Supporting them at their as their quest for the state champions continues on. So, all right, we've got Hayden Austin, Talon McMillan, Cole Oxley, Luke Summit in the game right now for CRA. Coles bring the ball down, has it top of the key. Riverside playing a pretty tough man-to-man defense right now. Cole with a good drive, but it's fouled. He'll get to go to the free throw line. Yeah, CRA is aggressive on defense, and they need to be. They're a little limited in size, and so I think it's going to be an issue for us most of the year. Getting into some foul trouble. We're just going to have to be a little more careful. Limit those fouls the best we can. Cole Oxley missed his first shot. He'll be taking a second one here. 19-4 with a minute to go. Riverside with the big lead. Cole up with the second shot. Misses it also. Riverside comes down with it, breaking away. Misses his layup. We get a breakaway here. Oxley gets it, hesitates. It's to Hayden. Hayden Austin came down with it, held on good, called timeout. This will be our second timeout for CRA. Put Appreciate all those that came out to the golf tournament last weekend, the CRA golf tournament. Kind of had a hiatus from CRA's golf tournament for several years now with COVID and such. Todd Sanders did a wonderful job organizing that, putting that together. Had a lot of good sponsors out there. And a little chilly out there, but wasn't as bad as we thought it would be, but it was a really, really well put together tournament. Appreciate all those that sponsored that and those that came out and played. Four seconds left in the quarter, coming out of our timeout here. Got the same crew that went into the timeout. CRA will have the basketball underneath their own basket. Sam Marshall bringing it in. Brings it out to Luke. Luke's looking around. Yeah, shot clock's a little bit different this year. Not that high school basketball ever is very slow. I don't even know that I've been to a game where it mattered that much. Maybe down the stretch in the fourth quarter in a close game it will. Luke Summit with the drive. Passes back out. Errant pass. Riverside with the ball in a 19-4 lead with 20 seconds to go. Riverside getting shot clocks off. Riverside going to probably play it down to the last shot. Not a big scoring night for so far for CRA. Riverside was going to hold it, but they had a wide open shot, so they took it. 5 seconds left. We just threw it away. Give it back to Riverside. Riverside goes up, misses their shot. End of the first quarter, 21-4. Luke Summit with two on the quarter. Cole Oxley with two as well. Hopefully we'll get into the second quarter and change things up a little bit. We're getting by them a little bit on the full court press, but we're not finishing off very good. But we'll take a break, get back with you when the second quarter starts. Here myself on here. We'll see. There we go. 21-4, 8 minutes to go for halftime. See what we can change things up here a little bit. Luke Summit with two fouls. Cole Oxley with one. Lathan with four. And Sam Marshall with one. CRA starts the ball out with the ball. Half court. Riverside's changed a few of their players up here. We can be a little more patient here on offense. They're playing a matchup zone, Riverside is. Luke kind of had the ball slapped away, but it was kind of stuck in his arms. They got called for traveling. Cole just went up for a block, but got an arm instead of a ball. The right idea. Riverside being run by Buster Campbell. He's been around a long, long time. I coached against him back in the late 80s, so he wasn't a young man back then. So he's been around a long time, but always seems to have successful programs. By the way, I'm Darryl Webb. David Watson is normally with us, but had other obligations tonight. He'll be back with us in a couple of games. I think he's going to miss Friday nights as well. So, Talon McMillan down with the rebound after a missed free throw. Riverside with a nice move. keep it from going out of bounds. That all that looked like it was off Riverside, but they're calling that off of CRA. 22-4 with 7 minutes to go in the first or second quarter. It's again good to have everybody with us tonight. Hopefully things pick up for CRA just a little bit here. Nice block by Cole. Riverside with the turnaround jump shot, but Cole was there and waiting. Knocked that down pretty good. Oh, nice play by Luke, and nice play by Cole. Luke with a nice dish off pass, and Cole finished it up and got fouled. So his chance for an old-fashioned three right here. Cole Oxley's got some smooth moves. I'd like to see him be a little bit more aggressive because he's got a lot more talent. He's just a little more hesitant and wants to get everybody involved, but I think he's got the ability to take charge out there if he'll just do it. Very heady player. Good kid, too. Riverside working around the top of the key, driving into the basket. Hayden Austin with a great block. Hayden's got some height on him and took advantage of it right there. It was a nice play. Sam Marshall with the shot. A little force right there. Riverside comes down with the rebound. Coming inside. Luke's little outmanned right there by about 6 inches. Riverside makes that basket. That'd be Gillis. He's got quite a bit of their scoring tonight, maybe about half their points. So Talon with the pass to Luke. Luke with a little jump shot. Almost went, didn't go. Hayden puts it back up. Hayden with the rebound. He got fouled on the foot back and will be going to the line. Hayden just a 10th grader, but getting some playing time tonight. Got some foul trouble on the side. This will help in him with his playing maturity, getting more minutes like this. Starter for the junior high team last year, and I think he grew another 2 or 3 inches this summer, so he'll be a good player for us down the road, if not already. Just sunk that free throw. Hayden puts them both in. Attaboy. Had some troubles last year with our free throws, so maybe got kind of a new set of players this year. We've got the same core for the most part that playing. There are a few players that decided that they were not going to play this year. Riverside with the three-pointer missed it. They'll get the ball underneath their own basket. 5:32 to play, 24-8. Start off a little better this second quarter. Just need to keep it up. Oh, there's another foul. Into Tom McMillan with the foul. He kind of got beat by a step by the Riverside player, number 15. He made the basket and the free throw, so there's 3-point play by Riverside. Talon, another one of our 10th graders, getting some playing time tonight. Passing around the perimeter. Luke with the jump pass over Sam Marshall. Luke handing off to Cole. Cole throwing it into Hayden. Passed up a shot opportunity. Sam Marshall from, got the rebound but couldn't put the ball back in. Riverside likes to run. We really don't even need a shot clock tonight. It's just kind of a foul. This one this time is on Sam Marshall. This will be his second foul. So we've got 4-2-2-2 already in the foul category. Riverside missing their first free throw. They've not been real successful in their free throw attempts tonight, but they've done everything else pretty well. They played pretty good defense. That one does go down 28-8, 4:50 to go in the ball game. Sam Marshall bringing the ball down, passes off to Hayden. Working around the perimeter, Cole makes a drive. Here he goes again. Oh! Called a charge against Cole. That'll be three on him, so we can't afford to lose Cole at this stage of the game. Putting a little bit of full court pressure on him, not much, just kind of a what do you got kind of pressure, but they broke it pretty easily. Not sure we need to do much more pressure with having foul trouble right now. We don't need to get any more fouls. Riverside trying to drive in. And they make it again inside. We're not getting a lot of stops in the paint right now. 30-8, Riverside up with 4 minutes to go in the game. CRA down on the half court. Had a reach around and a steal. Riverside comes up with it. Nice play to get it out. Easy basket for Riverside. It's a nice play on their behalf. Game's getting a little bit out of hand a little early on here. We need to get a couple of buckets and a couple of stops to turn this momentum over a little bit. Luke Summit up at the top, takes a little 10-foot jumper, misses it. Hayden with the rebound, puts it back up, and almost goes down, but does not. That was off of Riverside underneath the basket. It'll be CRA's ball. Got a tie up. It'll be Riverside's ball. I got a token pressure right now at half court. Kind of a purpose of that kind of pressure is not to get an easy basket underneath, making the guards have to look around. They get a push out, drove in. Yeah, these Riverside players coming in, seeing Hayden. When Hayden puts his arms up, that's a pretty big tree to go around right there, and they have to double think whether they want to shoot it or not. 3 minutes left to go in the second quarter. Riverside 32, CRA 8. Sam Marshall with a long three, puts it down. Get a few more of those in order to turn some momentum here. Not unheard of to come back from a deficit like this, but got to do a few things differently. We got to play a little better and hope that they don't. We just got a Talon McMillan with a steal right there, trying to throw it underneath the basket. Sam Marshall from 3-point again. This time he's off the target a little bit, had a little more pressure on him that time. Probably forced that a little bit. Had a little traveling by Riverside, getting ahead of themselves. They've kind of got their second unit in right now. Bigger group, but obviously their second string. 2 minutes to go for halftime. Just had a throwaway ball there, Riverside. Nice little play by 15. He's got several of their points. Riverside up 34-11. Riverside knocked the ball away. Talon came down with it, passing around the perimeter. Sam Marshall with a shot from the corner, missed it. Got a foul if it's out of bounds. Okay, that's Luke Summit's third foul. Cole Cole Lemons checking in the game. I'm thinking he's coming in. He's coming in for Sam Marshall right now. I think Sam's a little winded. He's been doing a lot up and down the court here. A little frustrated with how the night's gone, which is easy to understand. Riverside with the missed free throw. Luke Summit comes down with it. May go all the way down. Takes it in. Doesn't finish. Oh. Luke. Missed a shot, and out of frustration came down and kind of hammered the guy in front of him. So he's got four fouls now. So Lathan and Luke with four. Minute 36 left in the first half. Hudson Inman checking in the game for Luke. Riverside puts the first two free throws down, 36 to 11. Second free throw up, and it is also good. Minute 36 to go. Cole bringing the ball down. Oh, nice play. Nice play. Cole Lemons with a wonderful pass to Hayden. Austin finishes it off. Excuse me, that wasn't Cole Lemons, that was Hudson Inman with the pass. Tom just had his pocket picked. Riverside comes down, puts it up, misses. Got a breakaway. Cole Oxley with the breakaway, nice pass down to him there. Didn't finish because he got fouled. A little frustrated he didn't finish. He'll be going to the line. Free throws. Thirty seconds left, 37 to 15. Riverside bringing it down, got their own rebound. Pretty good right now. Three-pointer blocked by Talon. No, that was by Cole. Cole Oxley with the block. CRA coming down. Cole Lemons with a good pass to Cole. Cole goes up. Triple teamed right now, and they're going to get a foul on Riverside. So Cole should know. Let's see if he goes to the line, if they'll call that in the act of shooting or not. Nope. Wasn't shooting, so we're getting the ball underneath the basket. Cole Lemons be taking it out. Passes to Hayden. Hayden gets fouled on his shot. He'll be going to the line. Hayden with a chance. He's made both free throw attempts that he had tonight, and he'll be back for two more. Just 1 second on the clock, so hopefully we'll be smart not to foul here. Hayden misses his first one. Hayden up with the second one, and it's up and just barely misses that one. We got another foul. Is that on? I believe that was foul on Cole Oxley, so we got four fouls on Luke, four fouls on Cole, four fouls on Lathan. And we're not done with this half just yet. Riverside misses the first of his two shots. 37 to 15. Second shot up, no good. And it's halftime. So in the half, it's 37-15. Riverside with a pretty sizable lead. In the half, Luke Summit with 2 points, Cole Oxley with six. Hayden Austin, two, and Sam Marshall has three. So Anyway, we'll see what comes out in the second half. I'm sure Coach will have some words of wisdom for these boys, and hopefully we'll start off with a little bit better. So anyway, we'll talk to you here in a little bit. second half. 37-15 right now. We've got a lot of foul trouble, so our bench is going to have to pick us up a little bit. Looks like our starters are coming from the get-go of the start of the game are back out. Luke, Cole, Talon, Lathan, and Sam. Riverside starting off with the ball, half court, three-pointer to go up, and it looked good from here but didn't fall. Kicked it back out. Sam's got a little one-on-two. Gets his shot blocked underneath. Had Luke outside if he'd looked for him. Nice block. Sam just came up with a block, two blocks. Talon with the foul underneath in the paint. Foul on the shot. Barroso for Riverside will be going to the line. First free throw up, nothing but net. 38-15 right now. Puts up second free throw, no good. Lathan with the rebound out to Sam. Riverside out with a 2-1-2 defense. Luke just drove to the hoop. Ball went out of bounds, gave it to us, but looked like his arm was hacked pretty good. No call on that play. Sam taking the ball out. Underneath to Lathan. Lathan gets fouled. Number 40, Couch from Riverside. Lathan will be going to the line. Some of our CRA volleyball girls have made it back to support their senior boys basketball game. Good to see them here. Lathan misses both free throws. Riverside knocks ball out of bounds. Luke will be taking it out. Riverside still with their 2-3 defense. Out to the top with Talon. Sam Marshall with the long three-pointer, no good. Talon over the back. Be his second foul for the night. Riverside bringing up the court. CRA in man-to-man right now. Cole Oxley with a good steal. Brings it up, throws it to Talon. Talon back to Cole. Cole takes it up and in. Oh, they're calling a charge. I don't know about that. That was a nice play. Refs, for the most part tonight, doing a pretty good job. That particular call withstanding. Riverside, once again, several of their second unit are in the ball game. CRA still playing their man-to-man. Got bumped right there. Riverside with another hoop, 40-15. Luke with the drive, nice play, Luke. Drove to the baseline, came in, banked it off real. Soft and nice. See a little more of that. Luke has some pretty good touch around the basket. Riverside with turnaround jump shot, no good. Lathan Brinkley down with the rebound. Sam down to Cole Lemons. Cole Lemons with a three-pointer, just a little bit short. Don't foul Sam. Riverside comes down, nice play. Little fade away. Not sure what happened on that play. Looks like Sam Marshall may have got poked in the eye right there. He's in some kind of pain. I'm not sure what it is, though. Yeah, he's grabbing his eyes. I think he got poked in the eyes. I think the referees probably didn't see that. Hudson Inman into the game. Luke with the pass inside, gets deflected. We come back up with it. Cole with a three-pointer, no good. But Lathan following up with that one. That was a nice play. It's his first two for tonight. Riverside from downtown, 45-19. He was pretty deep on that one. Nobody was out there guarding him. Probably didn't think he'd shoot from that far out, but he did, and he made it. Riverside with the steal coming in. No good. Oh, Luke. Look like Luke Summit is probably going to come up with his fifth foul, and that'll be it for him. It is his fifth foul. And Luke will be calling it done for the night with 4:34 left in the third quarter. Hard when you get four fouls in the first quarter not to – he's just aggressive by nature. It's tough to back off from being that way if that's who you are, and that's who he is. He's a great defender, but pay a price for it on the foul sometimes, and he has tonight. Another foul on CRA. This one will be on Hudson Inman. It'll be his first foul on the night. Next foul by CRA, and Riverside will be in the bonus. Riverside working around. They've slowed it down a little bit, too. They've got their second unit in the game right now. Driving the basket, flipped it out to three, long three, no good. Riverside wanted that rebound a little more than we did right there. Lathan Brinkley with his fifth foul. Can tell he wasn't real happy about getting that one. So there's two of our starters out with 4 minutes to go in the third quarter. Traveling by Riverside. CRA working around the perimeter here with 3 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the ball game. Getting a little reckless with the ball. Riverside comes up with it. Riverside with an easy two underneath. Very young team out there right now. Foul on Cole, against Cole Oxley. Got four 10th graders out on the court right now with Cole. Talon McMillan with three-pointer up and no good. Gets his own rebound, comes back out. Drives to the basket, puts it back up again, off the back back to the rim. But we come up with the rebound again. So we're busting the glass pretty good. Cole drives in, almost gets it. Didn't quite, maybe a little foul on that play that didn't went uncalled. Getting a little physical out there tends to happen when score is this big of a difference and people getting tired. Riverside with three-pointer, no good. Push off on Riverside, CRA's ball. Cole gets it, drives it inside, puts it up, almost goes, but didn't. Got her own rebound. Cole Lemons with the three-pointer, that's also no good. Riverside with the rebound, they got a breakaway, and they don't score, and we get the rebound. Foul on Riverside. CRA has the length of court to go. Cole Oxley having the ball, bringing it down. He's also got four fouls. You have to be careful. Allen with the drive off the back of the rim, no good. Now, kind of the story of the night. CRA's been in foul trouble all night. Can't seem to get the ball to fall. Cole Oxley with the steal, goes up for the drive. Oh, halfway down and back out. Cole Lemons with the rebound, goes back up and gets fouled. It's a nice play, on both parts there by Cole Oxley and also by Cole Lemons. Cole quietly having a pretty good game out there, making an impact. First free throw up off the back of the rim, no good. Second free throw also no good. Riverside with the rebound, pushing it down the court. Riverside wanting to take a deep, deep three right there, but thought better of it. Stage the game, everybody's wanting to get a little action. CRA with a foul, that's going to be on Cole. And Cole will now be out of the game. So, three of our starters are now out of the game with five fouls with minute 31 to go. Cole had him a pretty good game. Quite a few rebounds, had a few buckets just barely coming in and out of there. Played good defense. Cole's always a solid basketball player, pretty heady. Involves the rest of his team. Side missed their first free throw, puts the second one in. It's 48-19 with a minute and a half to go. Talon bringing the ball down. Long three by Hudson Inman, no good. Irons kind of being unkind to us tonight on our shots. Sam Marshall back in the game after he like he got poked in the eye a little bit, but he's also got to be careful. He's got a couple of fouls on his own. He's got to kind of run the show right now. The only senior left out on the court. Hayden Austin with the rebound. Hayden getting in there. Hayden also having a quietly a good ball game. His presence inside has been noticed and has made Riverside, he just got hammered right there. Oh, good, they called that. Well, he'll be going, they don't got the bonus just yet. But Hayden's had a good presence in the paint. Riverside driving in, and he gets his arms up, and they think better of it to go up for their shots. Cole Lemons be taking the ball out right now. Passes into Hayden. Hayden back out. Talon. Talon misses a shot. Yeah, there we go. Cole Lemons will get the rebound. Kick it back out to Cole. Cole makes three-pointer. Good on Cole right there. Riverside answers with two of their own. 20 seconds left to go. 50-22. Sam Marshall dribbles the length of court. Pops a three from the top of the key. We've half the score. 50-25, six seconds left to go. Riverside up, banks it off, no good. The Riverside ball with 2.5 seconds left to go in the quarter. Riverside with the shot, up, no good. End of the third quarter, 50-25. Take this opportunity to once again thank those that participated in our CRA golf tournament. It was told just a little bit ago that it raised $14,000, and appreciate all the sponsors that took place, that took part in that and made that such a success. CRA relies so much on those types of things, and we're just so grateful to have the people that are part of CRA to participate in such a way that we can have successful events like that that help raise money for different things for this school. It's a great school, and it's great to be a part of this, and appreciate y'all. Be back in just a minute. Welcome back. Starting up the fourth quarter. Took a minute to get back. Just talking to some of our CRA volleyball girls. Who did make it back for the senior game? Asked them if they wanted to talk about it. They said no. So they wanted to talk to me about it. They just want to talk to you about it on there here. Riverside with the ball. 50-25. 7.5 minutes to go. Riverside throws up a shot. No good. Side with a deep three, also no good. Sam Marshall with the ball, brings across half court, looks like he's going to drive all the way in. Puts up a shot about 8 feet, off the back of the iron. Riverside down with the rebound. Got their big boys back in the game. It's their, some of their bench players, but big boys off with the three-point air ball there. Cole Lemons with the rebound, comes, brings it all the way down, passes it off. Nice play right there. Got off to Talon McMillan. Talon scores the bucket. Good to see our 10th graders working so well together out there. Kind of forced into a little more time tonight. One of the Riverside bench players just made a three. Their crowd pretty excited about that. Sam Marshall drives in, kind of forces it up a little bit, misses, but off a Riverside player. 6:25 to go with 53-27. Cole with an inbounds play. Passes into Hayden Austin. Hayden goes in for the shot, gets hacked on the wrist. He'll be going to the line for two. Hayden with his first shot up, nothing but net. Hadn't been at the line several times tonight. Up with the second shot, it's up and it's also good. Playing a little full court man-to-man right now. Possibly a little too little, too late, but got some fresh legs out there with our 10th grade boys, and they're ready and willing to do whatever coach wants them to do here. CRA with the breakaway. Sam Marshall gets a steal, going to go in all the way. Puts it up left-handed. In and out. Riverside down with the rebound. Got a man wide open. He didn't see him underneath the basket. Ray's still playing a little man-to-man. Riverside with a deep, deep three. No good. Hayden Osh with the rebound. Passes off to Cole. Cole takes it in, gets it blocked away. Could have been called a foul right there. No call made off of us. Riverside ball. On Hudson Inman right there. Riverside with first shot, first shot up and good. Second shot up and in. Marshall bring the ball down. Puts it around their point guard. Working around the key. Passes back out to Hayden. Hayden into Hudson Inman. Hudson up with a shot off the back of the iron. Riverside, a big hurry down the court. Score two there. Reserves having their way with it right now. Sam Marshall with three-pointer up, no good. Hayden in with the rebound. Turns around, gets it to Hudson Inman. Big, big teardrop shot. That one just about hit the rafters. Cole Lemon's playing some good defense on their point guard right now. Playing some good man-to-man right now. Keeping their scoring in check. Hudson Inman with the foul. Looked like a jump ball right there. Looked like he had all ball on that. But Zebras didn't see it that way. So they'll be going to the line for two free throws. 57-31 with 4:16 to go in the game. Puts up the first free throw. And it is good. Second free throw, also good. 4:16 left in the ball game, 59-31. Sam Marshall driving in. Gets pickpocked right there. Riverside off to the races. And they score again. This unit out there right now for Riverside scoring more than their starters. Nice drive by Cole Lemon, just a little bit short on his shot. Riverside with the score again. Sam Marshall gets it, goes coast to coast. 63-33. Mercy rule will be in effect. 3:16 to go in the ball game. Riverside with the shot down low. Tyler McMillan with the drive inside, went up with a nice shot, but was hacked on the arm. Shot didn't go, but he'll be going to the line. Talon up with free throw, up and in. Second shot up, and this one does not go in, but we get the rebound. Hudson Inman with the... That wasn't... That was Hayden Austin with the rebound right there. Sam Marshall up with the shot. It's good. Sam having a good second half right here. 65-36. Riverside just working around. They're not really looking too heartily for a shot right now. Hayden with the steal from inside. Riverside with the ball. Drive inside, gets cut off by Sam. Looking inside, found his guy inside, up, no good. Hayden Austin with the rebound. Hayden's got quite a few boards tonight. Sam Marshall in, again, in and out that time. Iron's not been too kind to us, even in our good shots. Minute left in the game, 65-36. Hayden Austin with steal, going to go coast to coast. Goes coast to coast, makes basket, and is fouled. He'll be going to the line again. Nice little sequence of events right there. Not bad for a 10th grade big man going coast to coast. Made it look easy right there. Misses his free throw. It should be, look like it's out on Riverside. This point of the game, it doesn't really matter. Clock's not stopping. Riverside bringing the ball in. 15 seconds to go. Riverside loses the handle. CRA get one more shot at it before this ball game's over. Brings ball in, 6 seconds to go. Sam Marshall with the three, and he puts it in. All right, 65-41 will be our final score tonight. Sam Marshall, our leading scorer. I'm not sure what the totals are on that. I've got, hate to say them because I might be wrong, trying to do a little bit extra tonight. But anyway, good finish to a rough game, rough outing for the boys. But they'll live and learn from this, and hopefully Friday night they'll come out better for it. But thank you for joining us tonight. I hope you all have a good night, and we will see you again on Friday.